Thank you. Would I invite Mr. Patrick Ehime, please, from the Gospel of St. Luke, chapter 21, verses 15 to 20. And the theme of the reading is The Shepherd Found Mary and Joseph and a Baby. Thank you very much. Praise the Lord. At this juncture, my brothers and sisters in Christ, having gone this far, we are now going to take a gospel reading. The person to proclaim the gospel reading is Reverend Father Press Osaiji. As the gospel is being read, please, we are all going to rise on our feet to hear the gospel. The Lord be with you. Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. In the beginning was the Word. The Word was with God. And the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things came to be. Not one thing had its being, but all that came to be had life in him. And that life was the light of men. A light that shines in the dark. A light that darkness could not overpower. He was in the world. That had his through him, and the world did not know him. He came to his own domain, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who did accept him, he gave power to become children of God. To all who believed in the name of him, who was born not out of human thought or will of man, but of God himself. The Word was made flesh. He lived among us. And we saw his glory. The glory that is his as the only Son of the Father, full of grace and truth. The Gospel of the Lord.
Now I invite the diocese of the speaker, very Reverend Father John McKibben, to give us the sermon of today.
Meaningful readings from the scriptures to keep us alert the joyful expectation of the God who comes to give us new life without end. And as the food, drinks, and merrymaking, there is all to the celebration of Christmas. Without Christians, Christmas period calls for a deeper reflection on our encounter with the newborn infant Jesus. The church set aside 4 whole weeks to enable us to be spiritually stimulated to adopt the humanity of God and try to remain.
Able to touch the life of many who are going astray.
due to not only the Christian, we are not praising Nelson today because he was a Catholic. After all, married 3 times or more, so he cannot be a Catholic. And many others that are praising him, they are not praising him either because he was an Anglican, but because he was a good man who promoted justice. So please, when we praise, as we are praising him, and we take this lesson from Christ himself, Jesus Christ taught us how to forgive. Let us always remember that life that Nelson Mandela led, the life of the spirit of forgiveness. And to return us to God, we have to return everything that He has our closeness to Him. And that which we pray for us to live in peace and harmony with our Lord. As we have just declared the year of faith, 2013, our celebration comes up with a new direction. As children who have renewed our faith in Jesus, confess our sins and reject all occasions of sins in commission or vocation. My dear brothers and sisters, may the Almighty God lead you back safely to your respective homes, and I wish you all Merry Christmas and prosperous New Year through Christ and the Lord.
Thank you very much. Let us put our hands together for our people.